Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. If you'd like any of your Ramadan related questions answered this month, you can email us at questions@amau.org.
وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
The question we're going to be answering today is as follows. Can I pray the Eid prayer at home?
So there have been a lot of people asking questions about the Eid prayer and how to perform the Eid prayer in a time where it is, for most of us, we will not be able to attend the Eid prayer in congregation. So let's start with the easy option first of all, that for those of you who are able to attend the Eid prayer in congregation, and there is an Eid prayer that is happening in your locality, that is being organized properly in your locality, then that is the simple option. You go and you pray the Eid with the people, and there is no harm if you have to keep social distancing measures. Some of the scholars, they gave a fatwa that the social distancing measures don't invalidate any of the prayers. So if a person is able to go to the Eid prayer and there is an Eid prayer where they are, and they maintain social distancing measures if they're required to do so. It's not the asal in our prayer. The asal is we make the rows close together. But if a person is required to do that, then inshallah ta'ala, it doesn't invalidate the prayer. And they have a fatwa from some of the people of knowledge to support that. As for the majority of us who will be praying Eid prayer at home, let us look at a fatwa that was given by the legend at Da'imah, and it was given by Sheikh ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala, and others who were on the legend at the time, who said, وَمَنْ فَاتَتْهُ وَأَحَبَّ قَضَاءَهَا إِسْتَحَبَّ لَهُ ذَلِكَ فَيُصَلِّيهَا عَلَى صِفَتِهَا مِنْ دُونِ خُطْبَةٍ بَعْدَهَا. وَبِهَذَا قَالَ الْإِمَامُ مَالِكُ والشافعي وأحمد والنخعي وغيرهم من أهل العلم. They said that whoever misses out on the Eid prayer, because they weren't talking about whoever can't pray the Eid prayer, but whoever misses out on it for whatever reason and wants to make it up, it is recommended for them to do that. So the person prays it على صفتها. It's the first point. They pray the Eid prayer the way that you're meant to pray the Eid prayer, with the way the Eid prayer is prayed normally, without the khutbah afterwards. And the issue of the khutbah in our time is the one where some of the scholars, they said that we have to leave this issue and research it in more detail, because it's not clear when there is no khutbah in the country, should there be a khutbah done. But for the purpose of this answer, we're going to say without the khutbah. And the reason for that is two things. Number one, because we don't have a fatwa from our scholars telling us to give the khutbah. In fact, the fatwa that we have inclined towards not giving it. And number two, it's extremely hard for the majority of people at home who would struggle, maybe perhaps even with the Eid Salah, to lead the Eid Salah. It's even harder if we ask for them to do the khutbah. So we believe that at the moment, the position should be that there is not a khutbah after it, but it's just the Eid prayer in the description of it. And this is the opinion of Imam Malik and Shafi'i and Ahmed and Ibrahim and Nakhai and others from the people of knowledge, rahimallahu al-jami'. And they said in the fatwa, the scholars of the legend, they said, wal aslu fi dhalika qawluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam idha ataytum as-salah famshu wa alaykum as-sakinata wal waqar fama adraktum fasallu wa ma fatakum faqdu. They said that the basic principle is from the hadith: if you come to the prayer, go with tranquility and calm. Go slowly and tranquilly. So whatever you catch from the prayer, pray it. And whatever you miss, make it up. So they said that this is a basic principle, that we make up the prayers that we can't pray. And even more so in our time when there isn't an Eid prayer being held in the first place. And they also said, وَمَا رُوِيَ عَنْ أَنَسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْ أَنَّهُ كَانَ إِذَا فَاتَتْهُ صَلَاةُ الْعِيدِ مَعَ الْإِمَامِ جَمَعَ أَهْلَهُ وَمَوَالِيهِ ثُمَّ قَامَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ إِبْنِ أَبِي عُتْبَةِ مَوْلَاهِ فَيُصَلِّ بِهِمْ رَكَعَتَيْنِ يُكَبِّرُ فِيهِمَا. They said that it's what's narrated from Anas, that if he would miss the Eid prayer, then he would gather his family and his Mu'ali, the freed slaves, and Abdullah ibn Abi Utbah, he would lead them in the prayer, and he would make the takbirat of the same like the Eid prayer. They would make the takbirat like the Eid prayer, the same like the Eid prayer. So this is the fatwa of the Lajna al-Da'imah when they asked about making up the Eid prayer for the one who misses it. And some of our mashayikh in our time, Sheikh Sulaiman Ruhaili, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, they also applied the same principle to the situation that we are in this moment in time. So let's look at some of the sunan before the prayer, just remind ourselves. First of all, at-takbir, making the takbirat before the prayer. And the sifat at-takbir here is mutlaqa. It's not, there's no specific wording that you have to use. But the most deserving of the wordings are those which are reported from the Sahaba. From those which are reported from the Sahaba, Ibn Mas'ud, it's reported from him that the takbirat he would make before the prayer is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah wallahu akbar, Allahu Akbar walillahi alhamd. This is authentically reported from Ibn Mas'ud. As for Salman al-Farisi radiyallahu an, he used to say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar kabira. That's also from the authentic reports. And also from the authentic reports is the statement Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar walillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar wa ajal, Allahu Akbar ala ma hadana. This is also narrated from Ibn Abbas and Sheikh al-Albani. He said it is sahih. It's authentically reported from Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. But the original principle in this is what Allah Azza wa Jal told us in the Qur'an, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. That you complete the prescribed number of days and you make takbir. However you make the takbirat, there is no harm in that, inshaAllah. But it's most deserving to use the alfaz, the words that were reported from the Sahaba, radiyallahu anhum. From the things we should do also before the Eid prayer is to eat. And that is to demonstrate the difference between Ramadan and the day of Eid, and the fact that the day of Eid is yawmu aklin wa shurb wa dhikrin lillah. It's a day of eating and drinking and remembering Allah. In the days of Eid, the days of A'yad, the days of Eid generally are days of eating and drinking. They're not days of fasting. So you eat something before that to demonstrate and to single out Eid that it's not a day of fasting. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first thing he would begin with when he would go out to the musalla is the salah. So even if there was a khutbah, the khutbah would be after the salah because of what al-Bukhari narrated from Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu an. Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yakhruju yawm al-fitr wal adha ila al-musalla fa awwalu shay'in yabda'u bihi as-salah. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go out on the day of al-fitr and al-adha to the musalla. He wouldn't pray in his masjid, he would go out into the open land, to the place where he would pray, the musalla, and the first thing that he would begin with was the salah. So we have the takbirat that come before on the day of Eid, before the salah, and then you make the salah, the salat of Eid. And to explain to you the Eid prayer in a simple way, because a lot of people might not be familiar with it and might not remember, it's only twice a year that you pray it, so it's easy to forget. Is I want you to think of the Eid prayer like the Fajr prayer. It's 2 rak'at. It's read aloud, just like you would read Fajr, or just like you would read Jumu'ah. Think of it like you would read the Jumu'ah prayer. 2 rak'at, and it's read aloud. Just like that, except for one difference, and that is there are some extra takbirat. Allahu Akbar is said more than that. So if it was the Jumu'ah prayer, how would you pray it? You'd make the takbir, you would make dua al-istiftah, you would say Allahu Akbar, then you would make your dua, Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, tabarak ismuk wa ta'ala jadduk wa la ilaha ghayruk, a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, and then you would read Surah Al-Fatiha, right? That's how you would do if you were, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and you would read Surah Al-Fatiha, just like the Imam would read it in Jumu'ah. So the Eid prayer is going to be the same format, but the difference is you're going to make takbir more. Now, some of the scholars, they said, does it come before dua al-istiftah? Does it come after dua al-istiftah? We want to make it simple for this answer. We're going to say it doesn't matter, whichever you do. Doesn't matter whether you do it before you say dua al-istiftah, or whether you make the dua subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik and then you do the extra ones, it doesn't matter. And the extra ones, they are 6 extra in the first raka'ah. That means 7 in total. And the scholars differed. Some of them said 7 extra, making 8 in total. But again, just to make it simple, because we don't want to overcomplicate things, for the purpose of this answer, I'm just going to go with my preferred opinion on the issue, which is that it is 7 including takbiratul ihram. 7 including takbiratul ihram. So that is, you make your first Allahu Akbar, and then 6 more. And you can raise your hands with them as well. Allahu Akbar, that's 2. Allahu Akbar, that's 3. Allahu Akbar, that's 4. Allahu Akbar, that's 5. Allahu Akbar, that's 6. Allahu Akbar, that's 7. And then you're going to start with your, if you haven't done your opening dua, you do it. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, and you read Surah Al-Fatiha aloud. Now the Prophet ﷺ had certain surahs that he would read in the Eid prayer. If you know them and you can read them, alhamdulillah, that's excellent. But if you don't, you can read any surah after Fatiha that you want. So the surahs he would read, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is he would read Qaf in the first raka'ah after Fatiha. He would read Qaf wal Qur'an Majid. And in the second raka'ah after Fatiha, he would read Surah Al-Qamar, اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. And sometimes he would read in the first raka'ah, سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. And in the second one, هل أتاك حديث الغاشية. So the first raka'ah goes as normal after the takbirat. There's nothing extra, nothing different. Then after that, you do your ruku', you stand up, you do your sujood, and so on. When you stand up for the second raka'ah, you make a takbir as you're getting up, right? Like from sujood, you're in sujood, subhana rabbi al-a'la, subhana rabbi al-a'la, subhana rabbi al-a'la, then you stand up. As you stand up, you say Allahu Akbar. That one's not counted. After you've stood up, you make 5 more. You make 5 more. And that is, so you've said subhana rabbi al-a'la, subhana rabbi al-a'la, subhana rabbi al-a'la. You stood up, Allahu Akbar, you're standing now. Now you're going to make 5 takbirat. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And that makes 5. That's 5 after you've stood up. So you stood up, you made 5 takbirat, and then you read again Surah Al-Fatiha and your second surah, which, as we said, if you know it, it would be Surah Al-Qamar. اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. And if you don't know it, then it would you could read Al-Ghashiyah. هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ الْغَاشِيَةِ. And if you didn't know either of those two, then you can read whatever Allah made easy for you to read from the Qur'an. And what remains is to congratulate the people on the day of Eid. And from the things the Salaf used to say, rahimahumullah ta'ala, is they used to say to each other, تَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ مِنَّا وَمِنْكُمْ. May Allah accept from us and from you. تَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ مِنَّا وَمِنْكُمْ. May Allah accept from us and from you. And Shaykh ibn Thaymin, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, ما جرت به العادة. He said, وليس ممنوع شرعا. Whatever is customary for people to say, like if people say عيدكم مبارك, or people say كل عام وأنتم بخير, may every year go by and you're in the best of health, or people say may your Eid be مبارك, there is no harm in this. There is no harm in this. As long as they're not saying something haram شرعا, there is no harm in what people customarily say to each other on Eid, like Eid Mubarak or something like that. There is no harm in that. But what the Salaf used to say, rahimahullah ta'ala, is تقبل الله منا ومنكم. May Allah accept from us and from you. So that's a brief description of the Eid prayer. We hope that's been helpful for people to implement that at home. Please don't be shy of it or worried about it, inshallah. Follow the sunnah and implement it at home if you're not able to go out and pray Eid with the congregation. Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best. والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.